Hi, my name is Kayla Michelle, and I am a fashion model turned fitness crossover model. And the reason why I started crossover was I was living in New York for a while as a runway model and loved it, still love it, but I wanted to do something to inspire girls and women to live healthier lifestyles than what I was seeing in the fashion industry and what I was experiencing in the fashion industry personally. So I branched out and crossed over into fitness, started a business and a career in fitness as a personal trainer and a transformation coach, and now I'm reaching back out into the fashion industry. Transformation, it started on a mental level because I first empowered myself through knowledge when I realized that I had an eating disorder and I was damaging myself. It scared me. I had a wake up moment and realized that I'd passed out because I wasn't feeding myself. I wasn't fueling myself on a primal level, taking care of myself in a way that supported my goals, which at the time was to be a model. So even as a model, knowing I needed to be thin, I knew something wasn't right because I wasn't healthy. If you're passing out, you're not healthy. I find different designers inspiring for different reasons, and I have a lot of respect and admiration for designers who are able to put collections out that specifically encourage women to dress romantically and femininely. Elements that I find really inspiring for clothing are enough structure that shows some inspiration behind the design itself, but doesn't distract from a woman's figure. And one way that I find designers do that really well is with the wrap waist style or the high waist style that really accentuates a tinier waist juxtaposed to shoulders and hips. And then something that I like too are more of the throwback to the 20s and 30s style, where we've got cowl draping of fabrics and beautiful trains and different things that show just enough skin in a really beautiful way, but it's the fabric is really complementing the woman's complexion, and the way that the fabric flows complements the way that her hair moves, different things like that that are just really, it's a play up of the individual that's wearing the clothing. I grew up a dancer and a mixed martial artist, so I've always been very active and very physical, and so this turned into another challenge for me to conquer day in and day out at the gym and choreograph. As a dancer, I love choreography, and every workout I do is like a choreography routine for me. I fell in love with muscle, and I fell in love with the process of building muscle and the process of taking my body through different peaks and valleys with my bikini competitions and seeing what I was capable of, challenging myself with weight training, sprints, intervals, different things, and it just became fun. My gym time, a lot of times, is, I call it my church, because it's my spiritual sanctuary. It's so well balanced and feels so empowered on multiple levels. Now my goal is to be able to be that support system and that inspiration and encouragement to other girls, girls that are in that place now, because our culture values beauty. It values being attractive, and it's a powerful thing to be attractive. So I think there's a lot of good in that, and a lot of good can come from being beautiful and attractive, but it's how you utilize it and how are we teaching our next generation to own that beauty and exemplify beauty. Where does beauty actually come from? Is it coming from the products? Is it coming from implants and butt injections? Or is it coming from who you are and being the best version of yourself, taking care of yourself on a molecular level with your health and fitness, your nutrition, and then owning that and running with it from there?